any question? How are you reading this? Okay. Yeah, your response. How are you reading this? Okay.
Yeah.
You get use of the terminology.
Yeah. It's confusing at times, but you know.
You get use of that. Mm-hmm. And like you just mentioned, this Thursday we talk about the four jhanas. Since you have not attained that state of mind yet, so sometimes you can learn the words. You don't feel that yet until you get to that point, until you meet, who knows, in the future, right? If you have time for yourself, later, I don't know when, but this is just the knowledge for you.
And that's one of my main difficulties is that I'm reading about it, but because I haven't never experienced it, it's hard for me to like actually get into it and like actually think about it deeper than, well, like how it's supposed to be thought about, because I never experienced it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. In class, we learn chemistry.
Yeah.
We could not see the chemicals, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, yes, we can smell, but sometimes even, yes, we can touch, but we don't know how they react to each other until we go to the lab.
Right.
Even when we study physics, you have to go to the lab too to see to recognize the velocity, the speed of light and so forth. Let's go beyond our flesh eye to recognize. So there is this meditation. Only when you sit down and practice, you can feel that. Otherwise, not easy. That's why the practicum is so important. That you could feel when you are mindful, it's quite different mindset in the form. While you walking, while you talking, all the time. Okay. All right, okay, so today we talk about five hindrances. So last time we talked about the five mindfulness, the body, mindfulness of the feeling, mindfulness of the mind, mindfulness of the Dharma, of everything. So that's a practice. So those teaching guide us how to be mindful with ourselves, our inner thought, as well as the environment. That's the whole aspect of this practice. And when you go to meditation centers, yes, most of the time they may talk about breath meditation or chanting. That's 10 people are doing at the centers, not much in detail. So that's why you come to this class. You learn more in principle, our theories first, so that you can understand and apply it on. So here, today we talk about the five hindrances. Whenever we do this, there's some type of obstructions that we need to recognize. When we are driving, we have to know that we have to be careful with some kind of blocks, like trees, so that we can maneuver over, otherwise we may encounter accidents. So there's meditations. So when you go to school too, it's all kind of obstruction, right? All kind of difficulties you have to overcome. Taking GA test, while you still finish up what you have to do for the workforce, 6 classes, and all kind of things. And you have to deal with assignment, the homework, the tests, all kind of things you have to deal with. So that's the normal part of life. Right? So, but remember, only when you deal with the obstruction, you could strengthen your skill and determinations. Without taking a test, you would not learn much. Is that right?
Right.
If you say, oh, I can come to class and do nothing, so you don't have any motivations until you get some kind of test, some kind of assessment to motivate you. So that is the five hindrances. So, okay. Let's see. Yeah.
Number five, I think.
Yeah. Okay. Yes, number
10.
Two.
Oh, 10.
Ten. Okay. So please remember, be ready for our Saturday. Okay. You know the address, right?
Games Road.
Yeah. It's easy to find.
Yeah, GPS.
GPS is different. I remember that in the 80s and 90s, we just used the map. We don't have this type of technology.
Crazy.
Yeah. Whenever we went somewhere else, we had to use the map.
Isn't that dangerous when you're driving too? So you have to have someone in the passenger.
The passenger
seat.
Would pull
yeah.
up because my
yeah.
mom used to do that.
Yeah,
right?
The atlas thing.
Yes,
yeah.
like the book.
Yeah.
So right now you just punch. And it's yeah. And
yeah.
even there's some apps can lead you minute by minute, right? Road
yeah.
by road, right?
It's
easy.
Like real time. It's crazy. It really is.
And they help you to maneuver to the road that
accidents
not traffic
and
much, right?
To let you know, like, maybe a more efficient route to take instead.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're spoiled.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Okay.
Nice.
What are we use was Waze, is that right?
Waze.
Yes.
You know when the cops are coming, too.
Yeah,
it has, like, a police tracker.
Waze?
Yeah, it alerts you that, hey, there's a cop on your route.
Girl, why would you tell me this?
don't use
my
it.
My friend has this thing in his car. It's like a
police
little
driver.
Beeper.
Yeah,
yeah.
Like it'll beep if there's a police in the air, so he'll slow down.
Yeah.
It'll like notify you. I'm just like, oh,
that's nice.
Okay. Okay. So
Waze.
Yeah. Waze.
I did use this recently. Okay, let's move on there. There's five engines. Before I move on, so again, whichever thing we do, we have some kind of difficulties. So that's why we need to learn more. And I think this session is not much harder than the next one. This Thursday we talk about four jhanas. Again, try your best to do some research, and I give you some kind of explanation based upon scientific point of view, and I got some. Powerful is still interesting, it's related to your brain. This is one of a psychologist, a doctor. He made that type of interlink between these four Buddhist genres with the activities of our brain. It's still interesting. Yeah, of course, 100 years before, we could not have this kind of information, but now we can see that type of interlink between the practice of our mind and how it transforms our brain. You guys know the term neuroplasticity?
Is it like the way your brain changes?
Uh-huh. Your brain can shrink and expand, depending upon how you use your mind. Like for the elderly people, if they retire and do nothing, it's easy for them to go down. But if they retire and they do more activities, physically and mentally, they're more healthy.
Mm-hmm.
It's not talking about young people like you guys. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's been interesting to understand more aspects. Alright, so we go over the five hindrances. I think it's just common. Most of them are common sense. When you do practice, especially meditation, those are the obstructions in your mind. There's no way for you to calm your mind if you still harbor this type of five basic things. That's what we need to learn and understand them. Of course, let them go or overcome them. So the first one, ill will, everyone knows this is the boiling water. This is that's what? Anger.
Resentment.
This is anger, yeah. The first one is essentially is only for one by one. Ill will, mental restlessness, laziness, doubt, and so forth. Here, this is the observing the path, feeling. This is what we learned here before. So again, before I move on, I want to repeat that you know, I base upon the traditional paths, so that we learn step by step how. The Buddhist meditation progress through the times. That's why sometimes you say, I read some of your comment that it's just repetition. But remember, let's say, let me go back here. For example, the question. Ordinary state, concentrate mind, is you may encounter the five aggregates again, right? Because they're based on that type of traditional structures. So that after this class, you understand generally how Buddhist meditation progresses throughout the times, from the early times to the Luminous Sun up to now. So if and again, you don't need to do all the questions. You pick up one, the one that you feel comfortable with. Right? Yeah, so since we don't have much time to go over it one by one, so I just go over the general information about this. So most of you done up to 9, right?
Yes.
Very good then. So no problems at all? That's good. And hopefully when they get I think sometime next week, and after that, I think it's more interesting when we talk about this exhibition. It's a lot of life story. Yeah, that it is not much rigid right now, but at least you understand. What's the number, please?
Number two. What two?
Three or two. Is this one here? Three?
Yes, three.
Okay. So you have my address for Saturday?
I actually have a test.
Oh, okay.
So.
Yeah, I have work.
Work?
Yeah.
You too?
I couldn't get my shift covered. I asked like everyone that there's like a birthday party going on for one of the coworkers, and I thought they could all take it off. So I tried to like work the the afternoon shift, but the girl said she had something, so I really couldn't.
Oh, really? So,
yeah, I'm still trying to figure it out, but I'm probably gonna go.
You can?
Yeah, I'm just. I'm probably just gonna figure it out.
So I give you the option, right? You remember?
Yeah.
You can go to Audi Sanders by yourself. But it's a bit hard.
I didn't
want to
go by myself.
It's a bit hard, right? That's right. We need to do it together. It's much better because we are on the same pace.
Yeah.
You know. Okay. Yes?
I still don't know what to take. Like, I've been thinking about it.
The food?
The food. I don't know what to take.
What's that?
For the food? For the pasta?
Remember what I told you? A salad or anything?
Well, like a vegetable tree, like vegetables?
Yeah, I'm food this one.
You're just saying
that.
Yeah. Like, give us specific.
If you if you've been at the Chinese or Vietnamese restaurant,
you know some.
Oh, you
go there.
Yeah,
pho?
Yeah.
You can go to some like Vietnamese or like vegetarian Vietnamese restaurants that serve or like actually prepare like catering.
Okay.
And it's like you just get a couple boxes of it.
I think that's what.
Don't worry much about it. We'll be repair something tonight.
Okay.
Chips and dip.
Peanut butter.
So is it for lunch or lunch time? We eat it for lunch?
Yeah.
Okay. Lunch.
We learn how to eat in microwave.
Okay.
That's a practice too. Yes, yeah.
Really
no.
Eat microwave?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's what is different from the way that we eat it every day. If this is this time, I don't know. Of course, we can have that option, right? Go to art center, but you don't know, you don't practice much.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
I'm gonna try
if we
beg for
the
girls.
Do we have a test? Yeah.
I have nothing to test. It's like
12:30. Yeah, 30 to when?
I don't know. Usually like 2 hours.
In here, so.
Yeah. And probably in an hour. I don't know what the exact is. I can learn it.
Okay.
It's in the CDB, it should be.
Most likely, yeah.
What's that?
The Classroom and Business Building, CASA, where you have to sign in.
Oh, it's not CASA. They just take us to our auditorium. We all do it at once. I don't. They did it last semester too. They make you do it on Saturdays. I don't know why. I don't know why.
Okay. But. 12? You said 12:30?
12:30. I pulled the syllabus.
That's okay. You live nearby the campus?
I live
where?
An hour away from here.
Where? North?
Yeah, north.
North?
Yeah, north. It's north.
North, nearby the George Bush Airport?
In
that area?
I'm so bad at directions. Like the Woodlands, Spring, Tomball area?
Oh.
That's where.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Okay,
this is when we get to see.
Do you want me to come for like after I'm done?
Let me see.
Is it from 9 to 12?
9 to 1.
Nine
right?
to one.
9 to 1.
Okay. So I'm thinking either you go a bit early and leave early, or after this. I think it's better if you can go come early.
Right.
And leave early, that's okay too. If you
okay.
They don't mind.
I was gonna ask if I could go leave early.
Yeah, shorter. That's okay. As much as you. All right, so let me go back here. Yeah. Okay. Again. So this we learned here, and let's just go back to define hindrance. Okay, it obstructs our mental inclination. Okay, in Buddhism. And I showed you last time, the anger, the attachment, and ignorance is like the poisons. Remember we talked about that, right? Why anger is like the poison of our mind. Why?
It can lead us to do something that we might regret later.
Mm-hmm. It's all we see.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It makes us impulsive,
mm-hmm.
irrational.
Yeah.
It also harms your body too.
Yeah. I know every one of us has like an experience when we harbor that anger or hatred towards someone else. Can we sleep well?
No.
Can we eat well? No way.
Mm-hmm.
Can we function well? No way. It's like we swallow the poison. It's harmless. That's why I learned lesson in my life too. So it's better. Yes. As human, we still have some anger toward other people, but somehow can let us go after the next day. You understand? Sometimes, you know, in life, we cannot handle things that people say, people run to us, but at least, can you leave everything behind for the next day, after the next day? It's not easy, right? Until you have this kind of practice. Because you let go of your thought from your mind. So what's anger then? The big one. It's common sense. What's anger? What's anger?
Feelings of hate.
Mm-hmm.
Feeling of hate.
Okay.
And resentment. And frustration.
Mm-hmm. Why? Why do we have that kind of anger? What reason why we have anger?
Because
Because you're not happy with an aspect in your life or a person, so you kind of just want to push it out or shut it out.
Okay, what else? What else? So, what else? When you, like you say, when you don't get things that you expect to, right? When someone turns you down, right? It just means something that you not satisfied with, right? Either with yourself and others. So, yeah. Right. And I hope that you never bought your laptop, right? Expensive, especially for Apple, right?
Yeah, like $2,000 you just bought.
Yeah. And when people are angry, they may not care much anything, right? You get lost, you know, people get lost. I think most of us have that kind of experience, is that right? Mm-hmm. Anger is basic human emotion. It's been by all people. Unless we calm our mind, otherwise we're still here. And to have that certain type of anger, be recognized, could be start something deeper, the relation of violent action, reaction. So you have to have that type of control. And everywhere, most of the time, especially the big companies and in the school, they have what they call anger management course. Mm-hmm. In psychology, do they talk about that?
Yeah, they do.
It's just specific course or
yes,
including
No, it's like if you, sometimes it's usually court ordered, so most likely someone did an illegal act or something criminal, and to avoid jail time, they're told to go to anger management classes, and a counselor will usually facilitate it,
mm-hmm.
but it's
no,
only
in... I mean, in the requirements...
Oh, no, it's not required, it's not required.
Not
required at all? No, it's like, I think it's, you have to take a licensing, but no, it's not required for us.
But in some your course later on, right, when you ready to be licensed scholarship, you need to have that type of training.
Yeah, exactly.
How to deal with angry people,
mm-hmm.
right? It's not easy to deal with them. Okay. Again, anger is emotion. Aggression is acting out inappropriately. It's not okay. Now. Is there any justification when we're angry to say something, to do something?
At the time, we think it's justified, but most of the time it's
most
not.
Time. Oh, okay. So, as me and this, no holy anger, right?
No,
nothing's called holy anger. When we act out anger, it's when we can control our emotions. We're not mindful with our emotion. That's what obstructs our mind. That's why when you sit there with so much anger in your mind, there's no way for you to calm your mind out. There's no way. Yeah. So this is so it goes hand in hand. When you do the practice, it helps you to cool out the fire. And during the day, you recognize us and you let it go. So it's helpful. Otherwise, when you have that type of anger, it's not
easy.
That's
Tate Collin Boulevard, Houston. In 400 feet,
you got that?
Turn right on Cougar
yeah,
Place,
I tried getting the app.
Then turn
oh,
right
because
okay.
She told me about the police.
So again, we know that aggression is different from anger. That's when we have much so much anger. This is why, again, frustration, that's why negative emotions, we feel hurt, frightened, disappointed, worried, embarrassed, or frustrated, feel the anger. Misunderstanding of poor communication between people, like your peers, your boyfriends, girlfriends, your professors, your employees, and so forth. Your employer is too great. So all kind of things, this is why we don't have the kind of right mindset in. Cause anger again. So again, this is preventable. We can handle it. To feel frustrated and angry at the same time, And when people don't respect others, you feel forced and so forth. This is understandable, right? So here, that's what can make people angry. With rudeness, tiredness, hunger, pain, withdraw from drugs, isolation. You angry when people don't have let's say if they are addicted with illegal drugs, is that right? They get angry?
Yes, most definitely.
Really?
It's a symptom of withdrawing from it.
Okay. Some physical condition, physical illness, mental illness, alcohol. Now, have you been in nursing home before?
Mm-hmm.
Most
yes.
of you, right? All of you, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know why the angry people, it's easy for them to be angry, you know why?
Because they're sad.
Yes, what else? Mentally, about physically, they're sick. Right? They ill, they don't function well as when they are reward when they were healthy, right? That's why it's easy for them to get angry. Absence. It happened to us too, right? When we're sick, we lie out there, and some people, I mean, even our family members, if they don't help us out, we may have that kind of angry, anger. And that's why it's understandable for the sick people, for the elderly people, to understand that. Injustice and so forth. So those are the reasons. The most common factor being tease, bully, humiliation, embarrassment, deadline, traffic jams. you get angry easily?
Yes.
Yeah. How can you deal with traffic jam? Mm.
Don't drive.
You turn up your music.
Put on music.
You turn up the music and you start dancing and let everybody watch you.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Well, this is, you know...
sloppy surface.
How about stoplight and street light?
Same procedure.
So again, if you view things in the past way, right? Taking how he mentioned that when you see the stop sign or the street light, just remind yourself to take a deep breath.
Mm-hmm.
That's a break for you. You understand that? Mm-hmm. But if if you say see in the negative way, oh no, I have to be in rush, I have to go to school early and so forth. It's just obstruction and you'll be angry. But nothing you can do, remember. Just accept the situation and move on. You cannot use your remote control to turn the green light on. No way, right? You can accept the situation, you make peace with yourself and move on. Otherwise, you harm yourself. And then that's the way you can deal with things. Disappointment, sloppy service, failure, infidelity, financial problems, being told you have serious illness, and so forth. All kinds of reasons. And all. This one, we have anger. So, and this is go over of these 12 type of angers. And I think, I don't want to spend much time about this. Let me show you a short clip, right? I think most of us recognize this too. Get a short one, okay? Not too long.
Muss nicht sein.
Ey, ihr ballert dort lieber lang.
Was ballert ich dort raus? Ich fahr mit 30 hier rum.
Ja, das Ding ist scheiße.
Das ist doch dein Problem. Scheiße, Alter. Wart. Ich glaube, der hat nämlich gegen mein Rücklicht gedreht.
It's okay. And have you seen people fighting on the road?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
No?
Uh-huh. My friend had a gun, like she stopped at a red light. The guy got out of his car, pulled out a gun and pointed at her window and told her to stay in her lane. And then got back in his car. Yeah.
What? Well, will you see them?
Okay. I mean, you see all the time.
People
just get really mad. They'll roll down the window, flick you off and stuff.
Yeah, well, this is just, you know, this life, right? So when you do, what do you do when people angry toward you on the road, especially it's the ranger, right? They couldn't control their emotion. They can use their car as the weapons, harm other people. So that's why. That's why we need to remember. This is the poisons. That's we need to let go. Otherwise, in our daily life, if we can handle that, we harm ourselves and others. I remember that a few years ago, I read an article. I talk about the young boy who was put in jail because he shot someone else when he was teenager. So he wrote a letter to the President Bush, George, the second one, that if you give me a second chance, I would make up my life. It's too late. Especially when someone if they are angry too much, they can use anything to harm others, to harm themselves, harm others. I used to tell a story that a few years ago, this one gentleman, his name is Cody. One night, he went back from work. He's a car mechanic. So when he got back home, he waited for his wife to step out from the car and shoot her. And after that, he went into the house and searched for his little daughters. But fortunately, she stayed with her friend's house. So after that, he shoot himself. And some of his friends put his relatives lead on that. He had some problems with his wife, as well as his mother-in-law, up to the point that he couldn't handle anything. And at that night, he tried to call many friends to cool his mind, but somehow many of them didn't respond to him. So they thought that it's just no more call. So there's no outlet for him to subdue that kind of anger. Up to the point that he killed his wife and himself. Of course, we don't know the last few days, right? Mm-hmm. We don't know what's happened with the student genre, but still, this is the tragedy that we need to recognize. This is life. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we cannot handle our emotion, and we cannot get back things that we want to, and it's too late to regret. So that's why meditation helps us to cool down this kind of anger, and vice versa. When we sit down, we need to let it go so that we can control our, we can come to bed and see things as the way they are. That's what remember I told you at the beginning, that when you focus your mind on any subject, don't focus on your enemy, right? Don't focus on things that you don't like, things that irritate you, that make you frustrated. Get focused on the neutral objects. Still to cool your mind. So he somehow spilled out, so that's...
What did he do to his bike? It looks like he cut something.
Yeah, it's the same.
God,
yeah.
I didn't know what the video was about.
Yeah. I just saw it right there, so like that.
The German threw me off, I don't know what was going on.
Yeah.
There's no context.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so here they list out all kind of anger behavior, verbal, passive, inflicted, chronic, judgmental, overwhelms, constructive, political, retired, paranoid, deliberate. What's been constructive anger? What do you think?
Constructive anger?
Like, people who, like, whenever they get mad, they actually could do something? Like, I don't know.
Probably, when you see a child.
Constructive criticism?
Yeah, the child who is touching to the fire, right? Mm-hmm. As parents, it's too far for you to stop them, stop that little child. So you may yell to that child.
Hey, stop playing the fire.
Stop that.
Right.
So it's not because of hatred, but because you care for that person, you care for that child. Paranoid anger, what is that?
Deliberate.
Like
he contemplated, and he thought about it.
And paranoid all times, like something.
Oh, paranoid anger?
Yeah, this one here.
Oh, like you think that something's coming for you, or
even
your back, or something.
Mm-hmm. Even sometimes someone says something about other people, other things, but you think, oh, that person talk about me. Right, you panel over that and so forth. It's be a good list then. Sometimes they say what they call the anger that's may pop up and go. It's much easier for you to recognize, but sometimes what they call passive anger is be harmful. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Like that gentleman, he suppressed that kind of anger. Like a hatred towards his wife and his mother-in-law for many days and months until the point he couldn't handle that. So don't keep that. It's like atomic, we keep the atomic bomb in our mind.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Right? So that's why I say that let's go. If, of course, during the day we have accomplice. By problems with other people, right? As probably it's out of the ignorance. We don't know how to deal with them, and they don't know how to deal with us. And that's why we have to kind of accomplish by problems. Just try to let go. So don't care on the next day. Have you ever had that experience that you could not sleep at night easily because of that kind of thought? That angry thought?
Mm-hmm.
It's harmful. The next day you retire, it's harmful for you, that's all. So just take care of yourself by letting go of this. Or let me skip all this. This is all the list. This is a long list. I don't want to go too deep about this thing. So in Buddhist approach, 16 are helpful to conquer ill will. Learn how to meditate on loving kindness. Remember we talked about that? It's so important. That's why at the beginning and then construct the class that you need to develop that type of loving kindness, meditation, meditations, forgiveness and joy of other people's success. So when we have that type of anger, learn how to meditate on loving kindness. How come? How we let's say if someone give us hard times most of the time, let's say you're annoyers, supervisor, or even professors, how could you develop the kind of loving kindness for that particular people? And the question was how? If, let's say, most of you are working now, right?
Mm-hmm.
So how could you deal with them then? How could you develop your loving kindness for the one who is there on their foot, who oppress you or who put you down most of the times? How so?
So like in my situation, like I work in sales and retail, so basically there's just so many people. It's just like if somebody is a jerk to you at some point during the day, within the next 5 minutes somebody else is going to come in and replace them anyways and kind of bring you a sense of happiness or something possibly. Or, you know, you just have some days where it's just consistently everybody just kind of sucks. But it's just like being able to know that life does go on past that point, and it's not going to hold any bearing to you
mm-hmm.
at the end of the day.
Yeah, I realize that they might be stressed, and like it might be an off day for them. Like, I work in a retail where we have like regular customers, and like some days they're like perfectly happy, and the next day they're just like so angry, and you just realize that obviously something happened in that day that just
mm-hmm.
just let it go.
I learned to like just disconnect from them because it's like if you let it get to you, I mean, what good is it going to do for you? You have to just like disconnect and realize it's not my fault, it's not their fault. Let me just not even, like, you can't give it any life because then it's going to bother you. And
a lot of times, like, they'll call back and they're like, I'm sorry that, like, I'm sorry I was like that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so I'm like, I don't really worry about it.
Okay.
As long as you don't get angry and you don't act it out, then.
Yeah. You want to believe the best in humanity, that nobody is truly a negativistic or person who harbors ill will. So you just
mm-hmm.
assume or hope that they're acting this way because of an external circumstance. Maybe their home life isn't great or they just got bad news.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's how I deal with that. I just think about if I were in their situation, I hope someone would understand me.
Yeah. For the loving kindness, what you could do, like how they said, just focus on what you know is positive about them, especially if you know the person.
Mm-hmm.
So just focus on their positivity. But like they said, like they didn't be having a bad day, you know? So you just gotta just let them love you.
Understand them by, what they say, step on their shoe, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But not easy. Not easy when you deal with this. If it's reputation, right? That person give you hard time almost every day. Sometimes once in a while, that's okay, that's a mistake. But then you know, right? Somehow that person watch you all the times, give you hard time. So how can you develop this type of loving kindness?
Kill them with kindness.
Huh?
Kill them with kindness. Show them the love that they're maybe not getting at home, or
mm-hmm.
give them a positive presence in their life.
And this is thing that people are told me all the time. Is that's what happened if they know you're so kind and they take advantage of you.
I wouldn't change myself for that one-off person. Like if they're gonna take advantage of you, they're gonna take advantage of anybody. So
mm-hmm. yeah,
I'm known for the really nice one at my job. So. They get me sometimes because I work in a pharmacy, but they're gonna get someone else anyway. So
if they keep that type of habit of hardness, they will get stuck with someone else later on.
Yeah.
Right. So the only thing is how we deal with this, how we deal with them. It's not easy, but still, I have. She working for a pharmacy, and somehow they lay her off. And she's so angry because anyways, it seemed to her that they discriminate her as a female, as an Asian, and so forth. And of course, for people, if what they call, if they want, they can sue, right? But it's not that discrimination, right?
Mm-hmm.
But still, in Buddhist view, this is somehow it's a karma we need to accept and move on. And she let go. Another thought that this was a lady in the mid-40s. She coughed most of times, and her family doctor kept prescribed Tylenol, aspirin, and so forth for her to take. And later on, one of her family members told her to ask a family doctor to send her to the specialist, and somehow because of her pressure, he did. And what happened? She was in the fourth stage of lung cancer. And she died a few months later. And her husband was so angry. She's still healthy. This basically, she's mid-40. So if the doctor, if I'm a doctor, could send her early, she may have saved her life. So if you were in that type of situation, you Lawrence or your wife or your husband, your loved one, because of malpractice from this type of doctor, what should you do then? Would you sue them? What should you do? It's not easy. That's why doctor, I think psychologist too, right? You have to buy the
insurance to liability to, yeah, to protect
this. You know, as human, you make mistakes.
Exactly.
So how could you deal with this kind of situation then?
Well, I guess when I always read articles about malpractice, I always sue to make it never happen again. Always, they want to make an example of, I guess, the malpractice. So I guess it wouldn't be about the money, but the spreading the awareness of,
I like to change policies.
Yeah, exactly. Make way so this wouldn't happen again to somebody else.
And even after the hurricane, you remember they released the water from the reservoir? Many people, right? How probably 1,000 people were angry, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it didn't happen to other people, but my house. And many of them are wealthy. So
I heard that they're suing because the city knew that they weren't supposed to build around it,
mm-hmm.
but they still did, and they didn't let the people know. So people are suing because the city knew not to build there, but they still built there because they knew it would flood if that was to ever happen.
So who fault? Is the city fault?
It's the city
to
fault.
To allow the people to build the house by the reservoir?
When they knew they shouldn't, because it's a floodplain. Like, they should have never built there, but they did it anyway.
Wait, so the city of Houston is suing?
No, the residents are suing the city because their houses are gone.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't know, but the city knew. So they're saying, like, it's negligence. Because they knew, but they didn't tell them.
The government needed to get sued.
Everybody gets sued.
Anyway, so So when, let's say, like you say, right, people sue each other so that it's got prevention, right?
Mm-hmm.
Not so that things won't be happen again. So is that the compassionate way? What do you think?
No.
Why not?
Because you're using your anger to cause you to, like, provoke you to do something. And in this case, it's suing somebody, so it's not a very friendly gesture either.
But money will never, ever, ever compare to a life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Ever, ever. But it will help.
I'm about my paper.
A husband to not have to worry about finances anymore, because funerals are expensive. He may have had children that he needs to take through college. They don't have another income. Suing is that, I don't know.
So, like in this kind of situation, would they move everyone around the reservoir out of the area?
They tried to evacuate them when they released that they were going to release the water. One of the students in my other classes, they said they went at like 3 a.m. and were knocking on the door.
Yeah.
But her parents didn't want to open the door because they thought it was like a robber coming. So they didn't know, like, to answer it or not answer it. So some people didn't get rescued because they didn't want to open the door at 3 a.m.
I mean, that after this type of mess, so would they move people out of the area, or they still allowed?
I'm going to assume so, because a lot of houses were damaged.
Mm-hmm.
But it's unfair because the city is raising taxes on all the houses to make up for the money to help pay off, you know, everything that's going on. So people are going to pay higher taxes on houses they don't have. So that's not fair either.
Still, it's not easy. It's not easy. These type of circumstances. So anyway, so depend on how we do things. Anyway, ideally, yeah, we try our best to develop that type of loving kindness, compassion to people, but still depend on the circumstances.
So what do you think the husband should do?
Huh?
What do you think the husband should do? What would, in Buddhist ideologies, what would he do?
Oh, the people around the reservoir?
No, the husband who lost his
husband,
wife.
I told him get let things go.
let it go.
It's not easy when you lost your wife, your lovely one. It's not easy to let go. But still, in Buddhist view, it's just the karma. It's just the karma. There's time for her to grow. So. But still, in the part that when you go to the court to follow the lawsuit, it maybe may get more frustration too. This may drain you and more energy.
Yes.
Of course, unless the doctor had intentions to harm her,
yeah.
Because it's, you know, because he worked part time. He's old.
The doctor.
He's old, and she just work. He's semi retired. That's why he didn't pay attention about the patient. His patient, yeah. That's why this is. So anyway, for this kind of situation, yes, no matter what, when we lost someone, especially a lovely one, it's not easy. Let's say even when we lost a laptop, computer, it's not easy to handle, especially all kind of information as you keep here.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned that if you have little children at home, and somehow they play around and put water on the laptop, or break your laptop. That's all information that you said here is gone, right? Of course, it's not easy to control the anger, but at least we know that just let things go and accept the situation, can move on. Or devoting oneself to meditation, love and kindness. That's why every day, if we can instill that type of love and kindness or compassion toward ourselves and toward other people. When we deal with things, it's easy for us to deal. Otherwise, if we wait until that type of situation occurs, it's not easy. That's when we have the type of training. Like, if you have this kind of information, right? It's better. It's better to prepare. Like, if you know in theory is how to fix a computer, right? But you have not done yet until the time is you need to fix. It's better for you to fix that than do not. You don't understand anything. Going to the last one is owner and heir of one action. Frequent reflection on whichever way. So again, being angry with another person, what can you do to him? Can you destroy his virtue and his other good qualities? So again, we need to have the kind of reflections. I don't know whether I told you guys this or not. So Dalai Lama, I used to quote Dalai Lama. Did I tell you that you have yet?
Mm-hmm.
Dalai Lama, he said that for the Buddhists, they respect him as a living Buddha. But for the Chinese communists, they see him as a wolf wearing the yellow robes. So he said, well, I'm a single person. Whether the people praise me or poop it out, I'm still who am I, that's all. You understand that? So again, if we angry with things, we cannot solve anything. If it is within our abilities, we can handle, otherwise just move on. There's this one here. Noble is a lot of things here. Noble friendship. We can hang around, we may hang around with friends, the good friends that advise us, give us suggestion to live in a healthy life. In the good life, all right, so whenever we encounter this kind of situation, then he give us some good advice. Otherwise, you know, we hang around with bad friends, you know, right? They give us some bad example of bad advice, suggestion. Can you imagine? But when you're so angry toward the person in front of you, and the third person may give you a knife or a stick and so forth. You understand that?
Mm-hmm.
So that's just the analogy. So again, if you stay around with the circle of good friends, spend them. And they give you their advice, suggestion to cool your mind, suitable conversation. All right, so this is the approach, especially with the loving kindness that we need to develop every day. Yeah, to see things the way that that's happening around us. It's what happened in political now, right? After the hurricane, they lost the electricity, and it's not easy for them to recover. But unfortunately for us, we live in this city and have each other to recover quickly. So that's the way we can think to develop our compassion and loving kindness to the unfortunate one. It's become our habitual patterns. In Buddhist views, before we do anything, we have certain type of reputation in our mind. You understand that? Let's say before, whether you say blessing to your friends or something that you related, but still, like I gave you that example, that story about the man who shoot his wife and his mother, his wife, because he has harbored constantly this kind of angry talk. So that's why we need to let things go. Alright, so that's the next one. The faith, that's another additional one still. Alright, so next one, we learned about this one, right? This is common sense, right? Last time we talked about this is one of the instruction to which is money is useful. Servant was a terrible master. Here we have to recognize, right? For example, cleaning. Let's say cleaning, routing, using grease at the craving for a clean sin. It was sent obtained. About email, everyone voice, right? We need to open email every day. Not even copy more than 10 times per day too. Yeah, this routing work. How about grieving for instruction? Get open. Sometimes we have time, so get open email for fun. To check, just to see whether our friends send anything yet, or anything news yet.
Yeah.
Of course now, unless you have some apps that prevents from the junk mail, right? Otherwise, all kinds of junk mail that they send to us. How about the school email?
Too many.
Too many?
Yeah.
Somehow I'm teaching at Indiana University. They have two step, right? Two step of verifications. Before you check email, it's more safer.
Yes.
We don't have here, right? Mm. I asked the IT man last year, but they say we don't have that. And sometimes be careful about the spyware.
The spam.
Mm-hmm. But still, anyway, go back here. Craving for instruction, of course. Again, we need to recognize whether we need them or not. Okay, from the words. This is due with the prevention from the sensory design or anything design. That's why we learned about the mindfulness of the body. Remember, some of you asked why we need to have that kind of mindfulness of the body. Again, this is up to us. We have many ways, many techniques that we like to approach. People, yes, they can absorb the breath or for other people, they recognize the impermanence of the body, impermanence of the thought, and so forth. So this is your knowledge. You need to learn So and so that you can pick up the best one for you. Garden Essence Door. Westmead, you know Westmead, the Garden Essence Door? Westmead. Westmead.
Not being overstimulated, whether it be like with your nose or with something you're hearing or just like kind of like moderation really.
Sometimes it's the especially for college student, if you guys stay in the dorm, right? You have Friday night. Do you have Friday night here? Or you go to Friday night party? That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, we have parties. Yeah.
For young people, there's no problem. But still, sometimes when I was in college, I remember that I stayed in the dorm. Back in the 80s, I saw many young people, especially I can say Friday night. After, that's why many students they don't like to study on Friday. Right? This is of course they like to take a good break, but still they drink, or they go out friends and so. Especially they drink too much, they couldn't control themselves and they be tired on the next day to study. Anyway, so this is one we need to recognize. And remember, we have a choice. Remember, I told you that when you're still young, most of you are only a mix of 20s. Your body is still young, you're still healthy. Try to eat healthy food. Try to sleep in a healthy way. Or try to have a healthy lifestyle. Because when you go up to 40, 50, and you see the impact of the food, of the drink, of this, with my age. It's not easy, that's why. And you observe your parents or grandparents, the way they eat, right, the way they sleep, it's not easy. So don't take it for granted. So if many young people, right, they don't care much about body, they keep stay late at night, drink all kinds of alcohols and so forth, and when they get a little bit older, that's all for them. Okay, so that's what moderation in eating, and good spiritual friendship, civil conversation. On this Saturday, when we have the what you call eating meditation, or eating in mindfulness way, in Buddhist view, the food, the drinks, is like a medicine. To keep this body intact, we need nutrition to live. That's why we just recognize the food. This is like the nutrition. This is like the medicine to keep us warm, to keep us working for the day. Mm-hmm. So that's that we would not attach too much system, or learn how to meditate on that. That's another one. Devoting to oneself to meditate on impurity, but all the same. Oh, the next one, doubt. What's wrong with doubt?
It hinders your ability.
Why?
Because you think that you're not good enough, or you won't be able to do it, so you don't even try. Mm-hmm. And you don't know until you try.
Mm-hmm. You won't do it. It holds you back.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What else? So, did you have the doubt before you go to school?
Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Then before you decide for your major?
Yes.
Right? Before you have an interview for your job? What kind of doubts that we have when we deal with things, especially the future?
Big decisions.
Mm-hmm.
Insecurities.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, how could you overcome the doubt then? If you know, even though that. Doubt that may be hindrance or maybe obstruction to your starting your work, and so how could you overcome that?
I feel like I overthink everything, but my thing is if it's something that I want to do, like I knew I wanted to go to school, mm-hmm. but then I was like, but then I don't have money to pay for it, I'm going to have to pay out of pocket, I'm going to get on a payment plan, I'm not going to have any money, and then I was like, I want to go to school, so I'm going to do it. So if it's something that you want to do, if it's something I want to do, then I'm going to do it. Mm-hmm. And that's how I get over it, because nothing's going to get done if I just keep thinking about it.
Mm-hmm. About what happened if someone has too much doubt about anything?
It hinders
everything.
I'm sorry?
Can they move on?
No.
You were stuck. You won't progress or
become
a better person.
Especially, you know, if people work in the in the justice department. I have one friend. He retired already. He was a policeman in Louisville, and he said it's a very stressful job for him because whenever he went out there on the street, he had that kind of mindset in toward certain type of people that they may be harmful to him and the communities. And this is disgraceful. So that's why it's better, I think, not to go with that kind of jobs. So you have to pick up the occupation. This just make your mind more peaceful. Mm-hmm. And how about, do you have double major? Do you have double major, minor and major one too?
Mm-hmm.
You don't have that double major?
Just a major and a minor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And did you decide your major when you were freshman or?
Long ago. Long ago.
Before?
Yeah, when I didn't want to do psychology.
When?
Maybe 4 or 5. 4 or 5 years old, I knew I wanted to do
psychology. Really?
Oh, yeah.
Wow, that's good then.
I knew I just wanted to, I love to talk. I love to help people.
Oh, really?
So
that's
I was just like,
then.
This is the perfect
when
job
you
for
were
me.
4 or 5 years
yes.
old?
Yes, I was like, mommy, I want to talk to people and
it's
help
not
people. She's like, you're going to be a psychologist. And
mm-hmm.
I was like, okay, cool. I didn't know what it was, but.
How about you guys? How about others? You decide of your major when you were in high school?
Like 2 months before I got into college.
2 months?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sounds about right.
It was because like I knew I wanted to do business, but at the same time I didn't know what exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And me and my best friend's dad, which is like my second dad, had a talk with me and he was like kind of pointed me in the right direction.
Mm-hmm.
And I chose. That was it.
What are you majoring
in? International business.
Nice.
Yeah.
How about others? You decided early on or sometime later? I have some student who come to me and ask what they're supposed to do. And even they're still in college.
Yep.
Freshman or sophomore, they don't know what they're doing. So it's better. It's better to have a goal for us to study. Otherwise, you jump here and then waste all your time and money too, right? If you switch a major, right?
One of my best friends, she switched her major her junior year of college. She's going to be here until 2020. She's going to spend almost 7 years in school.
That's me. I switched sophomore year.
So because you have a doubt for your career, right?
You're
not sure, right?
I only did my major when I went to college because I was in a program, a geology program in high school. So they gave me a full ride if I did geology. So I did geology because they paid for school.
Mm-hmm.
And when I moved back to Houston, I decided that it was not something that I wanted to do because it's very hard. It's a lot of work. Like,
mm-hmm.
It's very hard.
The Earth is crazy. It's crazy. Like,
so she did that?
And I changed, and she told me that it was going to take like another 3 years, and I'm going to be 25 next year, and I'm still here.
So that's why you need to, I advise the young people that they need to pick up the major.
And make sure
when they're freshmen.
You want to do, not something.
Yeah, anyway, so I love this. We don't have much time to talk much about it again. Why now is the problem when you do meditation? Why?
Because it will cloud your mind.
Uh-huh.
You won't be able to find peace.
When you sit there, if you have a doubt, I don't know whether it calmed down my mind or not. Can you sit still? There's no way. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
You have to have kind of confidence. That's why. That's why nowadays, the reason why many people, they they let the limitation because this all have some scientific proof. Because they have the machine, they, like the MRI, to scan the brain and to recognize the function of the brain that's changing. Mm-hmm. So from time to time, I will show you this Thursday too. So that we can recognize the benefit of meditation there. So there's no doubt at all. If you have time, if you dedicate your time to sit there for a while, you calm your mind. And you're much more clear. Without this type of scientific proof, it's not easy for people to use like meditation, but now it's just plenty. So a lot of things in doubt, but I want to move down here. So actually, this one here, one of the five hindrances for the six good of unwholesome mental factors, one of 14 unwholesome mental a lot. Feather is this obstruction. There's a lot in a book here, but let me move down. Here is a cynical doubt, negative and cynical sin, plot, explorative, the general doubt, dogma. It's too much easy to recognize. And sometimes you need to take challenge, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
If you don't take challenge, you would not be successful, or you would not overcome the problems, especially with the unwholesome things. This is not a term they put, but here again, don't believe your story until your mind tell. In one particular sutra, Buddha says, don't believe your mind until you attain what you are. That means when you calm your mind completely, why is that? Why you don't believe your mind? Is that different from self-confidence?
Mm-hmm.
Is it different? We need to have self-confidence, right?
Mm-hmm.
To believe in ourselves. Of course, the problem, yeah, the point, that's great. In Buddhist view, yes, we need to encourage people to have that self-confidence. You have confidence with the school to get diploma, to graduate, and so forth. But when we talk about don't believe story in your mind, remember a lot can happen in your mind, right? In our mind, every day, every moment. Some, let's say, when you're taking a test, right? Especially multiple choice, remember?
Mm-hmm.
You circle the first one if it's right, but later on you circle
mm-hmm.
the wrong one,
mm-hmm.
right? So remember, use the instant.
You're always right the first time.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Use instant.
Always.
Whether first, I don't know, first or second, but use instant. You use intuitions.
Mm-hmm.
And even, you know, when I was college, especially in my engineering major, to professors, they get all kinds of protest, oppression. But somehow, when I did it, after I did the question correctly, I didn't know why. But of course, I know, I used my instant. I know I use my intuition because you would not find the answer on the in the books.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes, you know, the questions the professor put on tests is through the experience to the so to test your intuition.
Yes.
Is that right? Especially since it's called scholarship,
right? Yeah.
So don't trust your anecdotal thinking part. It's a lot of things, so let me skip this one because we don't have much time. So let me go down here. We learn are knowledgeable. Yes, that's why we come here to study. Clarification through questioning, skillfulness in resist populism, much faith and confidence, good spiritual friendship, civil conversation. Listen here. This is the one to mention about, you know, many people, they have the doubt about others, especially strangers, whoever. It just happened to everyone first. So until we know them, right, we have no much doubt. You know, like one lady, African-American lady, she came to my center to stay for a few days after the flooding, And of course, you know, I have to deal with my people, my Buddhist people. They, wow, why didn't this lady go to other places and so forth? Of course, I sat down to talk with her to understand her situation, and I told my people, right, okay, you know, she came here to find a job, but somehow she ended up to share the apartment with her friends. But her friend's house was flooded, and she has nowhere to go. And so she went to talk with the social service people for Bend County, and they referred her to so that's why. To understand people's situation, so that we know you have, I'm doing nothing now, that we call, I wouldn't recognize. So I, during and after the storm, after hurricane, that's the big question. Could you host a stranger in your house? It's not easy, right? Until you know that person, right? So anyway, so that's why we can overcome the doubt. All right, so let me skip this. This is a lot, I put a lot of information here. The next one is the laziness. This happens to everyone, right? Especially when you go to school, you need to be diligent, right? Be on time, in class on time, to study hard. It's not like high school, that the teacher reminds you to study, do the way you work. So that's why in this practice, you need to have a kind of spiritual spirit to do meditation. All right, so the laziness is one of the obstructions for us. And let me talk about regret. We spend 1 more minute. What happened? What's been, why regretfulness? It's an obstruction for our practice. Why? Let's say, this is in the daily life. Why, if you harbor that kind of thought, you regret something that you have done in the past, this may hinder, this may obstruct your starting. Why?
Because you
don't
always keep on thinking, what if I did this, or what happened if I have done this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's why we learn the mistake from the past, right, and go on. Of course, actually, the boys who live with me, he took the calculus test yesterday, somehow he didn't do good in the test. I said, well, you still have three more chance, so keep moving on. All right, so anyway, so these are the obstruction, right, in red, the laziness, and of course, another one is sleepiness, too. This is things we don't have much time to cover. I think we'll pause this on the backboard view, right? Sleep enough for you to have energy, right? So that you can have energy to go to school, and we'll talk more about sleepiness on this Saturday too. Sleepiness is one of the main obstructions when we do meditation, mm-hmm. when we fall asleep.
Do we
need
to bring like a pillow or a mat?
We have plenty over there. Okay. All right, so see you on this. Okay.